Hello, everyone. Welcome to Mindset Moment. And let's have a conversation around mindset. And some people have asked me, why do I talk about mindset so very much? And there's a simple reason for that. What I see is no matter what you do, no matter what your career is, no matter where your place in life is, mindset affects us all. And so as much as I talk about brand building and personal branding and LinkedIn strategy and all of those things, at the root of everything, mindset, it leads your everyday focus. It leads your life. It leads your successes. It leads your failures even. And so I believe really strongly that having a great mindset is the foundation for everything that you can accomplish or that you go through in life. And that's one reason why it's such a strong foundation of what I talk about, of what I teach. And we're going to jump into that now. I promise today will be a really short one, getting everything done. And I'm actually using a new presentation tool, so we'll see how this goes as well. If you have any questions, you can pop those into the comments, and I'd love to hear from you as well. But let's talk about, for those that maybe don't know me, and this is your first time seeing me, my name is Sandy Adams, and I'm a brand strategist, a speaker, a photographer, a podcaster based in Memphis, Tennessee. I had somebody the other day reach out to me. She's like, wow, you do a lot of things. And I said, I don't do them all at the same time, but they all intersect. They all are a part of who I am. And I believe that there's that red thread that runs through everything that I do that all connects every aspect of my life. And as I said, mindset is a conversation that I want to have on a regular basis with all of you, because I think that that is something that can really help you be the best version of you. So let's talk about this quote by Ella Fitzgerald. It isn't where you came from, it's where you're going that counts. And that's kind of the foundation of this mindset moment today. It's, you know, we all have, as we grow up, we all suffer from how we grew up, or in what condition we grew up, or, you know, what people thought about us when we grew up. And that leads into our adult life. And so many times I see people that still struggle with who they were then versus who they are now. And that's something that I've also struggled with. I grew up in a really small southern town. I grew up on a farm. My father could not read or write. And strangely enough, that did not affect me, but it was always feeling less than that affected me. And maybe that is what was one of the things that drove me. But another aspect of my life that's been the guiding force was my mother. She passed away in 2016. I always remember her getting up and just continuing on with life, regardless of the circumstances, regardless of how many people put her down. She never let where she came from affect where she was going. And I think being raised by that mindset really helped set me up for life, regardless of whether or not we had money, regardless of whether, we had all these opportunities, which we did not have. So the other thing that, for some that you may not know, I've been teaching. I teach part-time for a nonprofit out of Houston, Texas. And I have probably, I was trying to figure out the exact number yesterday, at least 4,000 people in the past 5 years. 99% of them, mid-level executives. Most of them, college degrees. A good portion of them, master's degrees. And a high percentage with PhDs, all experienced, very knowledgeable people of society. And the common thread through all of them was that so often they let their job that they lost. They let their title that they lost affect and guide them to where they were going to go. Who you were yesterday is not who you are today. And you can't let things from the past affect the future. And it goes back to that growth mindset versus fixed mindset. We don't have to be the people that have succeeded the most in life have been the ones that knew that they could get better. The ones that knew that they could learn how to change things, that they could learn more, do more. And so if you are sitting there right this moment thinking about you're not good enough, or that's what people thought of you then. You know, I've had people that have looked me in the face and told me some harsh things, that I would never be this or never be that, or I wasn't funny. I may not be funny to everybody, but I'm funny to somebody. And those little judgments, just like your job title, affect how you perceive yourself if you let it. So if there's one guiding force that I want you to keep in mind today and going forward is that it isn't where you came from. It's where you're going that counts the most. And you can make that decision about where you're going each and every day. Your work does not define your worth. Your job title, it's not who you are. You see, when we were little kids, we grew up, we went to school, we decided what we wanted to be, we got a job, and we forgot what we wanted to be when we were little. You know, so many times I ask my students in classes, you know, what did you want to be when you grew up? 50% of them can't remember. When we get to adulthood and life takes over, we forget all of our dreams and our hopes for the future, for the most part. But your work does not define your worth. So if you are working in a job that you do not feel is your biggest potential, you can change that. It doesn't define who you are. I've worked at jobs that I hated. I've worked at jobs that I did not live up to the potential of. They didn't even use all of my skill sets at all. And I often wondered, is this my life? No, that's not your life. You see, you're so much more than your job title. You're so much more than your job. It is a portion of you. It's a portion of your life. So let's talk about a career is what you do. It doesn't have to reflect who you are. Making a job part of your identity is an option. It's not an obligation. And your impact in the world, it doesn't depend on how you make a living. It comes from how you live your values. Just like you have a family outside of work, you have hobbies outside of work, you get paid to do a job. But what you do outside that job, that can be bigger than everything. When I talk about personal branding, I talk about it is your reputation. It's what your passion is. But one of the first things that I try to do with my brand clients, especially individuals, is that your story, who you are, what you value, what your passions are, your story is above everything else. So a career is what you do. It does not have to be who you are. And the biggest thing I want you to take away from is don't quit. Just do it every day. You know, I've had people ask me so often, how is it that I stay motivated. And I do talk about my struggles. I talk about the lowest part of my day is very first thing in the morning when I open my eyes. I talk about that, you know, how I project on here. It doesn't mean that I'm not, that I don't have those unmotivating moments. I don't have those struggles because I do. It's just that I choose when I get up what I'm going to do that day. And there are times, and I've talked about how I struggle with anxiety these past few months. There are times when my mind focuses on 20 years from now, 10 years from now, 5 years from now, a year from now. And it's really great to focus on where you want to go. But if you let that focus stay there, you won't get done what needs to be done today. You see, the success does not come from the end result. The success comes from what you do every single day, the actions. Diane Sawyer just did an interview with Jeremy Rimmer. I just now lost my train of thought. See, he had that snowplow that ran over him back on New Year's Day. Horrific accident. He has to focus on taking every single day, one day at a time, keeping in mind his end result is walking again. But he has to focus on the actions, the therapy, the massages, the stimulating the muscles, the coping with the pain, the mental agony. You know, he talked about how it hurt him to know how much pain he put his family in, how he did that to them. So every day is a struggle for him to learn to walk again, for him to learn how to go through life without all of that baggage. He could easily quit. And we could all easily quit. But if we quit today, we're going to be the same place tomorrow. And so every morning when you get up, have a plan, make sure that you take some type of actions that day, because those actions get you one step closer to where you want to go. Now, I am teaching a live class next Thursday. It'll be through Zoom, and this gives you the opportunity to take action. See where I'm going with that? So this is a question that I ask so many people who are going through job search or even trying to get your next client. Why should they hire you? That's a question that you have to answer before every single interview, before every single client meeting. Can you answer why should they hire you? Can you essentially verbalize that into a marketing statement? And that marketing statement becomes your focus for that conversation. So join me. I'll be teaching via Zoom next Thursday, April 27th from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Central Time. The class will be about 45 minutes and then we'll have time for Q&A. You can register at this link right here. Whoops. At this link. See, I told you I was going to be doing this. At this link right here. And also, I'm going to pop it into the chat box as well. If you give me just a second, I'm going to do that right now and pop that into the chat, and it'll also be in the post as well. So I hope that you all join me for this class. It is something that I feel strongly about. It, you know, when it comes back to marketing yourself, building that personal brand, whether you want to or not, it's out there. I have so many people that don't even really understand why they need a personal brand. But the biggest question when you go into an interview is, why should they hire you? Not because you've got 15 years experience. And I'm going to dive into that myth, as well as so many other ones, and teach you some great interview strategies to go with that. So I hope to see you next Thursday, April 27th, from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Central Time. So thank you all for this mindset moment. I hope this has been something that is going to propel you to be active today and to push yourself a little bit farther. And if you had some great takeaway from today, pop it into the comment section afterwards or send me a direct message. I'd love to hear about how this has helped you. Crystal, she says, thank you. That is the question I really struggle with answering within interviews. Well, then great. Make sure that you sign up for my class for next Thursday, and we will dive into that as well. So thank you all for listening. I will be back next week with another Mindset Moment. Have a great weekend. Bye, guys.